First off, Microsoft To Do is available for free, and it also will pop up now as a new app that's part of Office 365. So if you're at work and you have a paid subscription, you can use it. It'll sync your tasks back and forth with Outlook, but not all of these features will go back and forth. The tasks will, but not the couple of things that we're going to go over here in a second. So hold on for that. So again, at the basic level, just go to the part that says to-dos, and it's a list of your tasks. If you left click on one, you can set a reminder at a specific date. You can set a due date, and you can set it to repeat at a specific interval. So if it's something you want to do every week, you set a repeat on here to have it tell you every week. And then there is a simple field for notes. Now, if you notice, you can't attach a file here. So that's a little bit different than Outlook, but it does keep it nice and light and simple. The other thing you can't do is assign these tasks to someone else. So this is just for your own use right now. So in addition to it just being a task list, one of the big new things that you can do is create lists. So I've made a couple of them here. Let's just look at fitness. Yeah, I already went out bike riding today, right? So I crossed it off. It sounds so nice. Let me do it for you again. Listen. So I went cycling, and all of these are the same theme, and it's a similar interface where you left click and you can set all these parameters. And I know you want to know. So if you want those little, what the heck do people call them? Emojis. Go up where you set the name in this text field, and then go over to the left and click on it. You have these different choices. And if you don't see what you want, you can surf the web and copy and paste emoji. I think that's where I got this one. You can also change the color of each of your tasks. If you get all hot when you work out, maybe you want it red. I made the purchases green, right? Because I'm spending money. So that's the one thing that makes To Do appealing versus just a simple task list is grouping things in lists. But the other thing that is kind of innovative as far as task lists go is the My Day function. Now I just went in here and removed everything. So let's start from scratch. This is what's gonna happen in the beginning of the day. You open up My Day and it's blank. So the thought is, you may have all of these tasks, you have them nicely categorized and they're dated, but you choose what you do that day. So I'm gonna start my day, I'm gonna go to this little smart suggestion, this does some of the thinking for you, and click on it, and it's gonna suggest things that you do today based on what you have in these lists and what the due dates are and possibly if they're recurring or not. So I decided clean my room is due today, but there's no way I'm doing that. I might make a video about To Do, even though that's due tomorrow. I'm in control of my list, right? So I'm going to add that. And then I really need to work out. So I'm probably going to do some cardio today. And I need to do the TPS reports, unfortunately. So I've added that. Say you're done. And just use the My Day list. Don't worry about all these other things. You've already decided what you're doing in your day. And you've made a list. You can left click and you can reorder it. I just holding down my left mouse key and I'm dragging it down. And if you get it done, mark it as completed. If you decide you're not going to do it, remove it from my day. I just left click here. This is the menu. If you don't want to do it now, but you want to keep it around, just move it to another list. If you decide you don't want to do it, just delete it. And that pretty much covers Microsoft To Do, and that's the good thing about it, right? There's not too much clutter with it. It's relatively simple. It just lets you organize what you're doing during the day. You can use it with Microsoft Outlook, and I think that they added Microsoft To Do but didn't replace the task in Outlook because so many people have used Outlook for so many years that they just want it to work that way. And also, if you flag an email for follow-up and Outlook, that adds it to your task, but it won't add it to Microsoft To Do. It is part of Office 365, so theoretically it could pick those up. So maybe in a future release, you'll see that. But do keep in mind that if you flag emails, they're gonna be in your task list in Outlook, but they're not gonna be here. And I think that about covers it. So I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. If you wanna see more, I make a lot of videos that are just similar to this. Go in the lower right-hand corner to subscribe and have a nice day.